increase in the job opportunities. Earlier we have started that businesses start with more than two people. So many people come and to start the business. So for that purpose, job opportunities are also being available over there. Business के लिए बहुत सारे people की ज़रूरत पड़ती है, because purchase department परचेज करने के लिए रॉ मटेरियल को परचेज करना है, सेल्स डिपार्टमेंट जो प्रोडक्शन किया है उसको सेल्स करने के लिए, प्रोडक्शन डिपार्टमेंट इज फॉर द प्रोडक्शन पर्पस, सो मैनी डिपार्टमेंट हैव टू बी अलॉटेड फॉर द बिजनेस एंड फॉर दैट पर्पस सो मैनी पीपल हैव टू बी एंगेज इन अ सिंगल बिजनेस. सो हियर सो मैनी जॉब अपॉर्चुनिटीज हैव टू बी डेवलप्ड एंड इंक्रीज इन द प्रॉफिट. व्हेन एवर बेस्ट यूटिलाइजेशन ऑफ रिसोर्सेज पॉसिबल एट दैट टाइम प्रॉफिट हैव टू बी मेड. So here, job opportunities are for social purpose and increase in the profit is for the ownership. Owner have to be do the business for the profit purpose. And best way utilization of the 6M, man, machine, material method. So that way, profit have to be developed. Then social benefit for the society, development is possible. Just like it is correlated with the job opportunities. Employees have to be away from the society only, and society's development is possible because employment get the salary. Then professionals are also coming from the society, just like a management, charter accountant, and so many we are getting the help of that in the business. So that are also from the society. So they are also paying, businessman is also paying the fees for, and businessman also getting the profit. So that all are very important, and for the benefit of the society that is very important. Just like entrepreneur get the profit, capitalized get the interest, and so many more. Next is a national motive. Whenever development of a business is possible, overall nation have to be developed, because with the job employees get salary, with the profit entrepreneur get the profit. Sorry. Salarized person have to get the salary, employees and entrepreneur get the profit, and capitalist get the interest. So overall nation have to be developed, because all the tasks have to be related with the society. Now next is our management is science, management is art, management is profession. In 2 months or 3 months, that is very important. Management is science as well as art. That is also one question will ask in the board exams. So that three tasks is very important. Separately that also will ask, or any two can be combined in the questions. So here management is a science. Science means what? Whenever we are doing any experiment in a science, so for that we have to follow the rules and principles. Then after we have to successful in the science doing the experiment. Same way here, some management gurus have also given the principles, rules for the successful of the business. So we have to follow that and we have to continue with the business. So it is why it is called the management is a science. Now next is management is art. Art means our work have to be present in a profitable manner. Just like whenever anybody is shouting on you, कोई आपके साथ झगड़ा कर रहा है, so at that time आपको उसके सामने जवाब देना है या नहीं देना, that is a skillfulness. अगर आप सामने जवाब दोगे तो वो बात बिगड़ जाए. Same way अगर business है, whenever business is correlated with these things, so here our work have to be present in a sincerity. Skillfulness, so that is very important. So management is art, and George R. Terry have given this quotation: science teaches one to know, art teaches one to do. So that are given by the George R. Terry, and that is a management guru best. Next is a management is a profession. Earlier we have seen that a professional. Any professional person have to get the fees, just like a doctor. Whenever you are sick, at that time you have to go to the consult to the doctor, and for that they are charging the fees. Okay, charge also fees. For that, management is also the profession. And for principals following this, business have to be successful, make successful, management is very important. Now some characteristics we have to see over here. First characteristics is a requirement of a specialized knowledge. Whenever you are having a class 1 in a school age, class 1, 2, 3, your level is increasing. Same way, whenever you are getting the knowledge of the management, you are increasing the knowledge, you have to add your knowledge and you have to make your knowledge in a beneficial way whenever it will be implemented to the business. So it requires a specialized knowledge, means particular field have to be decided. In this field only this management have to be, just like a science. In the science, a person have to get the MBA degree. Arts is also necessary, BCom is also necessary. But for making a doctor, a person want to be doctor, for that a person have to be science field area. Then only that have to be make the doctor degree. Same way here, requirement of specialized knowledge, particular field have to be necessary, increasing the knowledge and resources. Knowledge also have to be increased with the increase in the management degree. Professional association, just like you are studying in any school, just like a color of school and so many more schools are there, you are also having any school. So particular school you have to concern with the schooling level. Same way when you want to get the professional knowledge, you have to correlate with any institutional knowledge. Institution you have to connect, just like a Nirma. And for that professional association I have to continue with. Next is implementation of code of conduct. Just like in a school, you are having rules and regulations. Just like you have to come with a uniform, you have to follow the rules, you have to follow the instructions given by the teachers. Same way, management in a professional management, there are also code of conduct that have to be followed by each and every students of the institutions. Now, moral responsibilities. Whenever a person have to get the degree of management, just like MBA, BBA, that is MBA means Master in Business Organization, MBA in Master in BBA means Bachelor in Business Organization. Here, one person, example I am giving you, that one person has got the degree of a CA. He is chartering the accounts. And there are so many companies we have to charter the accounts. So first of all, he have to be loyal for that particular accounts. So here, moral responsibility is a person have to be loyal to their duties. Okay, so here some characteristics of management are over there. Okay, thank you. We have to continue with the next part.